health regulators giving the green light to resume two major COVID vaccine trials. Investigators found no evidence that the unexplained illnesses were related in any way to AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson's vaccine trials. That's according to the companies themselves. The NIH director, Dr. Francis Collins, joins us now. Are we getting close, or how would you characterize it?
I would say the pace of vaccine development since January has been unprecedented and rather breathtaking. When you consider normally every other vaccine we've ever tried to prepare has taken 4, 6, 8, 10 years. And here we are in October, expecting that if all goes well, we will have at least one vaccine that is proven safe and effective by the end of 2020. This has never been done before, never even close. And of course, everybody's concerned about, is it being done by cutting corners? I want to reassure everyone that the safety and the efficacy standards for these vaccines have never been higher.
The most common side effects are dry mouth, headache, constipation, and abdominal pain.
Headache, diarrhea, and abdominal pain.
Unexplained muscle pain or weakness.
Dry mouth and constipation.
Nausea, drowsiness, vomiting, and dizziness.
Headache, diarrhea, indigestion, and rash.
Trouble sleeping and vivid, unusual, or strange dreams.
Upper respiratory infection, stuffy or runny nose, and sore throat and headache.
Nosebleed or nasal sores, nasal fungal infection, glaucoma, or cataracts.
Decreased appetite, nausea or vomiting, dizziness, tiredness, and mood swings.
Fever, stiff muscles, and confusion. Uncontrollable muscle movements, an increased risk of death.
An increased risk of death or stroke.
A shortness of breath, swelling of your tongue or throat may occur and in rare cases may be fatal.
Bleeding and ulcers, which can occur without warning and may cause death.
Shortness of breath or swelling of your tongue or throat may occur and may be fatal.
You heard about the two trials that were stopped temporarily because somebody in the tens of thousands who were getting the vaccine or maybe a placebo got an illness and you wanted to be sure it wasn't connected, that's an indication of how serious the safety standards are.
Dr. Jha, I want to quickly just ask you this. What can you say to Americans like myself who may be a bit skeptical about the safety of these vaccines, given how quickly they came together? I mean, my understanding is that Moderna's vaccine was designed in just 2 days, for example. I mean, when the vaccine does become available, you know, will there be people that feel confident enough to take it?
Yeah, no, I totally get it, right? I understand people's hesitation, and this has gone fast. We got to look at the full set of data, but the data so far really do look like the vaccines are pretty safe.